Hey there, Vibrant family, and everyone that's joining us online today. First off, I just want to say a huge happy Mother's Day to all the moms out there. Mom, we love you so much, and we hope this day is a special one for you. You know, even though we're still meeting online, we hope that you get the most out of this service. So we encourage you to interact, engage in the comment section, and as always, like and share this message on your social media platforms so we can connect this message to the people that you're connected to. Speaking of connection, if that's something you're missing during this season, we don't want you to be alone. I want to encourage you to go to vibranthtx.com/lifegroups and connect with the Zoom life group there. As always, we hope that this message blesses you. And before we go into service, I just want to pray over you. Lord, I thank you so much that we can come together and we can worship you and we can hear what you have for us. I'm asking that during this time, Lord, that you would reach into the homes and the areas where people are watching this service and it would minister to them. You know, so much has changed during this time, but you don't change. You stay the same, and I'm asking you to continue to minister to those, to strengthen them, to encourage them, to lift them up. God, that something that would be sung or said today would impact them, it would bless them, and give them what they need. In Jesus' name, amen.
Good morning, Vibrant family. We're so happy to be with you this morning. Let's do something. Stand up off of your couch, in your living room, in your kitchen. Let's have some fun. Let's worship together. All right, amen.
Step out of the shadows. Step out of the grave. Break into the wild. And don't be afraid. Spaces, grace is waiting for you. Dance like the weight has been lifted. Grace is waiting. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. There is freedom. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. There is freedom. Come out of the dark, just as you are, into the
Yeah. walls. I thought by now they'd fall, but you have never failed me yet. I'm waiting for change to come, knowing the battle's won, for you have never failed.
And
thank you that you've never failed us. God, I thank you that you are always faithful and you're always on time. God, there has never been a point in our lives where your hand hasn't been right there with us. God, there has never been a moment in our lives where you have let us down, where you've turned your back on us. God, you are so faithful. God, you are the picture perfect example of faithfulness. God, I thank you that in your presence we can find freedom and joy, and that you will never forsake us. God, I thank you that we have examples throughout Scripture of how you have shown up and how you have made a way, and that we can draw strength from that right now. God, whatever it is we're facing, whatever the trial is that we find ourselves in the middle of, I thank you that we can draw strength from your word that shows us over and over and over again how you have moved mountains and how you have caused walls to fall and you've slain giants. God, you've done miraculous things, and that same power is at work in our lives. God, I thank you for that today. God, I thank you that we're never alone and you're never far from us. Lord, I thank you for each and every family that has gotten up this morning and made it a priority to bring your presence into their home. They've gathered their family and they're worshiping you right now. God, I thank you for that. I pray that you would be with us this morning. Lord, open our hearts and our minds to receive the word that you have for us today. I pray that you would speak into our lives, and God, help us to be forever changed. We give you all the praise and all the glory for what you're doing in our church and in our community in this season. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Thank you so much for worshiping with us today. Would you listen into our news?
Hey guys, I'm Haley, and I'm so glad you could join us for today's online service. If you're new to Vibrant, we'd love to connect. Fill out a connect card at vibranthtx.com/card, and we will reach out. The season we're in can be stressful and a little scary, but you're not alone. If you need prayer, fill out a prayer card at vibranthtx.com/pray, and one of our pastoral team members will call and pray with you over the phone this week. Giving is one of the many ways to worship. Now more than ever, we need to remember when we give our first fruits or tithe into the kingdom, he will always bless the remaining. You can help us reach people around the world with the good news of Jesus by giving online at vibranthtx.com/give. Normally at this time in our service, we would have you stand up and connect with somebody around you. Instead, take a selfie with your watch party crew, post it to your social media feed, and tag us. We will choose a few lucky winners and send you some free merch. Take a moment to do that, then we'll jump in today's message.
Mia, why do you think Mom is the bomb?
I think she paints my nose and makes it pretty, and now she takes care of me.
What about you, Brody?
Because she just takes care of us really good, and I just love her.
My mom, Sandra Ludi, is awesome because she always tells me to pursue my passions, music, arts. She's always there for me if I need to vent or cry or ask for advice. And she's just all around an incredible mother. And I love you, Mom. Happy Mother's Day.
So why do you love Mom?
Because I love her.
All right, man, why is your mom the bomb?
Because she loves me and she takes care of me. And she's there when I need her.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What else?
She helps me with the dishes.
My mom is a bomb because of her unfailing love and support. No matter what was going on in my life, she was always a rock for me. Thanks, Mom. I love you.
Mommy's a bomb that she can cook good, that she smells good.
Mommy's a bomb because she loves me because she is pretty.
My mom is thebomb.com because she takes care of us and supports us.
Tina is the bomb because she takes care of us and introduced me to Starbucks.
You're the bomb! Mom. We love you!
We love you!
Mom, I think you're the bomb because you're nice to me, you give me the best hugs, you watch movies with me, and you love us all the time.
Mom is the bomb. Mom is the bomb because I love snuggling with her, and sometimes she lets me have bars.
Our mom's the bomb because she teaches us and makes bomb food and does our laundry
and sacrifices her needs for those she loves
and gives without expecting anything in return.
My mom is the bomb because she's loving and caring.
My mom is the bomb because she gives the best advice and she's always there for me.
My mom is the bomb because she always puts other people first.
My mom is the best because she's always there whenever I need her.
My mom is fun to go places. She's funny and she's fun to hang out with. And I love her.
My mom is the bomb because she's so great.
My mom is the best because she always is watching us and she loves us and everything.
My mom is so beautiful.
My mom's the bomb because she's so beautiful.
Hey, Vibrant Church, happy Mother's Day. We're glad that you're here. Wasn't that video amazing? My mom is the bomb. My mom is the bomb. In fact, why don't you just like high five your mom right now and just tell her to say, my mom is the bomb. Just tell her, say right now in the room, my mom is the bomb. You know, today is Mother's Day and it's really all about honoring mom. It's about honoring mom. Now, I know this looks way different than you thought Mother's Day was going to look. Trust me, I understand that, okay? You thought it was, you know, going to be able to come to, you were coming to church and be able to take her to her favorite restaurant and all those things. I understand it looks way different, but I do believe today we can honor mom with the same fervency that we thought we could have, right? And so today is really all about honoring your mom. And you know, the image of the perfect mom raising the perfect kids looks great on a commercial or a Hallmark movie, right? It looks great there. But how many of you moms were feeling pretty good about life until you tried to take family pictures and you tried to get everybody to smile at the same time, right? It's almost literally impossible. I mean, you got one kid's got his finger in his nose and the other kid's got his finger in the other kid's ear, right? It's just almost impossible. The real world is that it's full of joy. Yes, motherhood is full of joy, but the real world is that it's full of work, tears, struggle, disappointment, hurts, and then joy again. And sometimes that happens all in one day. Irma Bombeck said, she once said, when my kids are crazy unruly, I use the biggest playpen that I can find. And then when they're finished, I get out. She hides in there. So being a mom is like a never-ending job with a never-ending pressure to be perfect, to be perfect, to be the perfect mom. You see that neighbor or your friend and you think that they're so amazing, so you strive to be that type of mom, but then you fall short of their social media highlight and you feel like a failure. Let me encourage you today, right now, mom, let me look at you. I'm talking to you, mom. God made you and planned for you to be the mom that you are today. God planned for you to be exactly where you are. God planned for you to have the kids exactly where they're at today. Grandparents, God planned for you to be able to spoil those kids as much as possible. God planned for that today. You know, one mom said, I'd like to be the ideal mother, but I'm too busy raising my own kids. I'm too busy raising my own kids today. Mom, you are the bomb. We see you. You've carried a baby for 9 months, went through all of the pain, the strife, the stress, the physical and emotional stress. You fed the baby all for that beautiful baby boy or baby girl to come out and say their first words. Dada. What is our responsibility as the rest of the family, dads and kids? What is our responsibility today? Today is all about honor. Today is all about honor. We stop where we're at in the middle of a pandemic when many of us have been home for months. We stop where we're at, and we honor mom. Mom, you're the bomb, and today is your day. Today I want to look at this word honor, and what does it mean? In fact, I want to do an experiment on three. Right now, wherever you're watching, I want you to say this aloud. I want you to give me what you think honor means, okay? If you're in a group of people or a watch party, I want you to, like, everybody say it once, okay? All right? What do you think honor means? Ready? One, two, three, go. Now, everybody probably said different things. Everybody, okay? And that's okay because many people don't know what that word means. And so really, to be honest with you, it's not a surprise that we live in a time that doesn't understand honoring somebody as special as your mother because we don't know how. We don't know how. In fact, the Bible gives us clear direction on how to do this. We're actually going to find this. We're going to go way on back to the Old Testament today, and we're going to start there. The Ten Commandments. We're going to start in the Ten Commandments today. Now, one statement that is true is that not everyone has had a child, but everyone has had a mom. Everyone has had a mom. There are ladies who are watching this today, and maybe you're by yourself even, that you've tried to have children and you cannot. And there are even moms that have lost children along the way. And I want you to know today, as your pastor, we stand with you and we love you and we're praying for you right now. We're praying with you, and I know that today is the hardest day of the year, and I want you to know that you have a church family that loves you and stands with you and lifts you up today. With God's grace and help and the people that God has put around you, you're going to make it through this, but I want you to know that we love you. Let's start out in Exodus 20 today. Exodus 20 and verse 12, it says, "Honor your father and your mother so that you may live long in the land the Lord your God is giving you." See, the Ten Commandments is a list of regulations that God really gave us in that time to create a healthy, God-honoring society. The interesting thing about every one of these commandments is that how they're written, every commandment besides this one was written that you shouldn't do this. You shouldn't do this or that. So, but this one is different. Why is that? Even the commandment talking about the Sabbath day talks about things that you should not do or things to not do on the Sabbath. See, this commandment connects long life and blessing to honor. That's a big deal. And here's something that you should write down right now. I want you to write this down. It's very important. God attaches blessing to honor. God attaches blessing to honor. He did it in the Old Testament. But also, he's still, today, that is still true. God attaches blessing to honor. And in fact, our family structure was where we first found honor, biblically. That was where that's the first place we learn it. It's the first place that we practice it. Our family structure is the first place that we learn it and we take it in. It's the plan, really the plan of God for us to be blessed. It begins with honor. When we look at the translation of this word, it gives us three definitions and three directions for us to practically honor mom today, this week, and really beyond Mother's Day. And so I want to go through these three definitions, and let's honor mom together, okay? So your first definition of this word honor means to give recognition of another's work. Give recognition of another's work. So what does that mean? I mean, that means that we should honor dads because they do all the work, right? No, I'm just kidding. It's a joke. Don't get mad, moms. It's a joke, right? We know that moms do the majority of the work in our homes. We understand that. And we find in the Old Testament actually placed a big importance on moms, and it recognized moms a lot. The common formula was to mention the kings of Israel was to mention the king, his character, and then his mother. The king, his character, and his mother. We find that all the way throughout
in referencing kings. And in fact, we move on to the New Testament and we find that Timothy was one of the first evangelists, but his faith was as a result of his mother's faith. And his mother's faith was a result of her mother's faith. So Timothy being one of the first evangelists was really the result of his grandmother's faith. Man, that's powerful. Think about the typical day of a mom waking up, changing only God knows how many diapers, and feeding three meals a day, cleaning the kitchen three times a day, making sure that the home is beautiful, making sure that cleaning the house, doing the dishes, doing the washing the clothes, doing all of these things. You know, one of my favorite things that Carmen does in our home is that when we get up and we're up out of the bed, she goes in, and it's very important to her to make the bed, and she makes the bed and makes it beautiful. It's when I walk into the room, I see that there's just a sense of peace that is in my home over that. You know, it's incredible to think about what the day in the life of a mom is like, and think about they do it day after day after day. You know, sometimes this word honor and means to pay someone for their due. It means to pay someone for their services. How much would moms be worth if they got paid for all that they did? We know there was actually a study on this, and it says that stay-at-home moms, if you got paid for everything that you did, you would make $162,000 a year. Wow. Man, $162,000 a year. Here's the deal, is that our moms really don't want money, though. They don't really want money. Well, I mean, depends on when they open up Home Goods again. They might want money then, but right, they don't really want money at their heart of hearts. They want recognition. They want honor and recognition. You know, that word honor means to make heavy. Make heavy in the original translation, to make heavy. And that doesn't really mean to picture or envision your mom with a few more LBs on, okay? That's not what that's meaning, okay? But what that means, that make heavy, it means that her words are heavy. Her actions are heavy to us. It means when she says something, it's a little bit more weighty on our hearts. It's a little bit more weighty in our minds and in our spirits. There's so much power in a simple thank you. In a simple thank you. I really appreciate all that you do for me. Thank you for being there and being you. Something that you could do to show your appreciation on a consistent basis, not just on Mother's Day. What if you handwrite a card for her? What if you handwrite a note to her? What if you just walked up and not because she did anything, but just surprised her and gave her a big hug? I promise you it would change her day. What if you gave her a break? What if you gave her a break and you tried doing the chores for a change? You recognize her for her work. The second definition that we're going to go through today is to respect mom. And this is the one that really seems to be a problem in most cases in our culture today. It's interesting to find the word honor has an antonym. It's defined, the antonym of that is shame. It's dishonor and disgrace. Some typical ways that we find disrespect to moms in today's culture is that maybe interrupting mom when she's talking, throwing her advice back in her face, maybe stomping your feet and slamming a door, or raising your voice to her, making fun of your mom, maybe saying, okay, boomer, right? Now, it's an antonym of respecting her. Proverbs 20 and 20 says, he who curses his father or his mother, his lamp will go out in time of darkness. When you're at the bottom of the valley, your lamp will go out. When you're in the roughest time, you won't know where to go because you can't see. Respecting your mom is how to illuminate your life. It's true. Now, I remember growing up, and my stepmother told me, Wendy Scobie, she was really my mom in my life. She told me, she said, how you treat me will be how you treat your wife. In the moment, I thought, that's crazy. But now, 20 years later, I go, huh, that's right. It's true. Some of the most successful and trustworthy people in history were ones that honored and respected their own mother. Let's move on to the third one so you guys will get a little bit less uncomfortable. The third one is to value something. Value is important here. When I was growing up, I used to collect trading cards. It was a really big deal to me to have baseball, football, basketball trading cards, and we would go and we would kind of, and that whole thing is about value, though. And I remember as a kid, I was growing up, I had a very valuable card that was worth a couple hundred dollars. And one of my friends had a card that really wasn't worth anything, but it was important to me. And so I traded my very valuable card for a Kobe Bryant high school card. And now I've got that card, and it's in great condition. And now that card that was worth maybe some pennies at that time now is worth over $2,000 the last time I checked. See, it's all about value. It's all about value in that moment, right? This is an inanimate object. What about valuing a person as important as your mom? The honor that your wife or your mom is receiving is really determined by the collective value of every person in that home. How every person in that home values the mom. See, your mom is a gift from God. How do you value her? She's a gift from God. Like those times that you would just spend time, kids, with your video games or your Xbox or your PlayStation or your Nintendo Switch or many other options. How many times do you just go and spend time with your mom because she's valuable? Because she's valuable. Dan and his friend had gotten off a couple of days from the Army Reserve summer camp, and they decided to, you know, call their moms to tell her, you know, tell them Happy Mother's Day, and they decided to take a trip to the beach for the weekend. And the sound of their mother's voice was very disappointed when they found out that the boys were not going to be home. To ease their guilty conscience of spending the entire weekend at the beach instead of with mom, they went to buy flowers, right? They went to buy flowers, and so they showed up to the florist, and they went to buy, and while waiting to purchase, they saw a little boy in front of them buying flowers for their mother, and the boy said, "I'm sure mom is going to love these. She always loved carnations. I'm going to buy them with some flowers and put them together with some flowers from our yard and take them to the cemetery." Instantly, it changed the mind frame of those two men. They dropped the notes in their trash, and they went back to their car, and they pulled up to Dan's house, and he said, "I'll see you Sunday night at 6. You know, I tried to find a deep theological connection and illustration to go with my mom is the bomb. And in all my searching, I found something that was pretty special. In fact, it's a very deep theological book, and it's called I Love My Mom with the Very Hungry Caterpillar. And so I want to read this to you because it connects with everything that we've talked about today. Can we read this together? Maybe some of you have this book. It says, I love my mom. Mom, you lift me up. You lift me up and hold me close. You are so wise, and you never forget me. Even when I monkey around or I get snappy, you show me the way and help me find my feet. And that's why I love you, Mom. I love you. Mom, I want to tell you today, you're the bomb. You are the bomb. You're the bomb today. Now, even when we don't recognize you, even when we don't give you the respect that you deserve, or even when we don't value you to the level that you're worth, Mom, you're the bomb. Now, when you think about a bomb, Mom, you're the bomb, and you're like a bomb, but not like an exploding bomb. You're more like a bath bomb. You're more like a bath bomb. You know, like moms, like these bath bombs that have many layers in them. They have many layers and ultimately have many different shades inside of them. Moms are deep. Moms have deep emotions and thoughts and feelings and a lot of wisdom. And moms play many roles in our lives, and they all come together to be who, really who God formed her to be in our lives. Moms are a lot like bath bombs because they're tough, but they're sensitive. They're tough. If you feel a bath bomb on the outside, it's tough, but it's sensitive. It's sensitive. When you place it in its purpose, it's sensitive. Moms are a lot like bath bombs because bath bombs bring a sweet smell to everything and every room that they're in. You know, for me personally, I know when Carmen walks in the room, our kids, their mind frames change. They smile a lot more. They're happier. Moms change the room when they come in. Moms change it. See, moms are a lot like bath bombs because they're small but powerful enough to change a room, to change an environment. See, moms are a lot like bath bombs because when the purpose of the bath bomb is unlocked and placed in water, it touches every part of the water and it changes the actual formation of the water. Did you know that water actually gets softer when it has a bath bomb in it? It gets softer. Today, Mom, I want to tell you, you're the bomb. We love you. We honor you. We respect you. We value you. We recognize you today for everything that you do, but most importantly, everything that you are. Thank you for being the pillar of our home. We love you. Today, I want to pray over all of our moms and our families today because I really do believe that healthy families are really the foundation of a healthy church. And today I want to pray over your family and pray over you today, Mom. Lord Jesus, I'm so thankful for all of the people watching this today, coming together on Mother's Day to honor the mom, the pillar of their home, the person that holds everything really together. God, I pray that you would encourage Mom today. Wherever she's at, no matter what she's dealing with mentally or emotionally, God, I pray that you would help her to recognize she is good enough. God, she is exactly who you've called her to be. So God, I pray that you would encourage her, that you would give her wisdom and strength, but you would also give her confidence to step in to who you've called her to be today. God, I pray that you would bless the families today as they honor the moms. God, I pray, your word says that blessing is attached to honor. So today, as we honor our moms, I pray that you would bless our families. I pray that you would bless them. God, give them great unity in their homes, favor in their homes. God, bind us together tighter than we've ever been. God, I pray that you would build a hedge of protection around every one of our homes, that I speak against division. I speak against strife and stress. God, I rebuke that in the name of Jesus. So we step into love. We step into unity that comes from honor and attached with blessing according to your word today. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. We love you guys so much. I pray that you have a great Mother's Day. Honor her big today. Why don't you go make her lunch and you do the dishes, all right? Moms, you relax. Have a great day. Be blessed.